If you need to, child, because I'm having a screwdriver, vodka and orange juice tonight. And I think I'm in the meantime, and while we're talking, I think in the meantime, I'm going to glaze over periodically at this delicious, scrumptious panini. It is a garden panini pasta. It's vegan, completely vegan. You guys, welcome to my channel. This is Kejean, my life, my motherfucking journey. Okay, so welcome, welcome, welcome. Share the video. Got some good news, right? It's about SRS. It's about gender reassignment surgery. It is about coochie. So, it's Friday. I know a lot of you guys are probably out having fun, but then a lot of you guys are also very smart and you're staying indoors and avoiding this pandemic, this corona. So, which is good. Here in Staten Island, this is now considered one of the hot spots for coronavirus. So I want everybody to be as safe and as cautious as possible during this time. Please, if you can avoid going around a bunch of people in a crowd, don't. Stay home. Have a cocktail, bitch. Throw on some music. Watch a movie. Something. Cook. Hell, I cooked a half a turkey tonight. It is big ass turkey, and I cooked half of it. Slowly going into the vegan era, slowly but surely. But I've been eating more vegan stuff than I've been eating meat lately. So I've been eating meat substitutes, but that turkey is definitely gonna, it had to be cooked because it was looking too good. So I had to cut it in half and cook half of that bitch tonight. Anyway. Y'all want to see it later? I'm going to show you at the end of the video what the turkey looks like. So, anywho. Oh, I also picked up this vegan mayonnaise today, guys. I didn't even know they had vegan Hellmann's. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? Oh, wow. Vegan mayonnaise. And guess what? I tasted it. I promise you. Now, I'll be the first to let you know. Look, girl. That don't taste too good. You know what I'm saying? But this, actually... Sweetie, this is pretty good. You know how when they always try to do a mayonnaise substitute or a low-calorie mayonnaise or something, and it has that oily aftertaste? Well, this doesn't. Oh my God, it's good. Tastes just like ice cream. No, I wouldn't go that far. But you don't miss a beat, though. Like, it has all the flavor of Hellmann's mayonnaise. Okay. A little different, not much. It's not so different that I'm going to go back to eating regular mayonnaise. I'm going to continue to buy Hellmann's vegan mayonnaise. So anyway, child, surgery. I'm so sorry I had to go through all of that, though, but I have some good news, and I just want to make sure that everybody is paying attention. So remember the last time I spoke to you guys, and I told you about my visit to Dr. See, I even forgot his name. Dr. Justine. I love this blouse. It's so pretty and soft and feminine. Anyway, gotta concentrate. Focus. Dr. Justine at Mount Sinai at 10 Union Square will not Well, you know what? I'm going to wait until after my consultation. But as of right now, I have my mind already made up. You guys know how I was. I've been on the fence about him doing my surgery, like, since I started. Because of the reviews, you guys. The reviews. I've been going back and forth. And I've been struggling. Really struggling in here. I even did a second consultation. And it's there on YouTube. You saw that. I did a second consultation. And the man was rude. In the visit, he was rude. He tried to be sarcastic. He did sarcasm with me, and I'm like, really? This is my life. This is my surgery. Like, you got one shot to get this right, MF. Don't sit here and try to be funny. Like, you trying to be shady? Oh, okay. You know, because he was like, I said, after I showed him all the proof and all the work that he had done in the real self work, where the girls were showing their pictures of the work that he had done, all the botchery that he had done to them, and how miserable and unhappy that they are now, and that they're, you know, they're mentally depressed and stuff. There's things that's going on now that they're suffering from because of him. So I said to him, what do you think about this? He says, well, I don't know. What do you think I should do, Kejing? Oh, we're doing that. We're doing that. But at the end of the visit, he was like, I promise you. He kept saying, well, why don't the girl come back to me? Why don't you come back? She doesn't want you to touch her anymore, I told him. She's not going to let you touch her with a 10-foot pole. Those are her exact words. And he was like, well, then there's nothing. Well, exactly. So she's getting her revisions done by Marcy Bowers, which I love Marcy Bowers, and that, I've been studying Marcy Bowers since the early 90s, her and Dr. Brassad in Canada. But anywho, so I left there feeling uneasy still, and I told you guys that in the video. First I said the visit went great, but then I came back and got really honest with you, because I didn't want to put a worse, you know, cloud over already what he already has online. But the truth is the truth, and I can't guide other girls. I felt an obligation to other girls coming behind me. I needed to let them know, look, yes, this is his work, and these are his results, and people have huge complaints, and everybody that he does comes back for a revision. Not for something minor, something serious. So I went and I spoke to, I had a visit the other day at NYU Langone with Dr. Rachel Bluebon. Let me tell you, Dr. Rachel Bluebon is amazing. Her work is amazing, top notch. The treatment that you're gonna get going there is completely different than the treatment that you get going to Mount Sinai. When I went in for my initial visit, I'm going to compare the two for a moment. When I went in, okay, so the other day I had a visit for this, right? I was going to see Dr. Eduardo Rodriguez for FFS, which is facial feminine surgery, to make my face look more softer or more feminine or whatever. But I've been on hormones since 1996, so it's done a really good job, I think, and even the doctor said so. But he said that I told him that there's things that I'm unhappy with, and I pointed those things out, and we're going for it. So I don't have a date yet for the facial surgery, but because I still have to do this CT scan of my face and all the bones and structure of my face, and he needs to see 3D images in order to go forward and making me a date. So that's the last step, and I've already made the appointment. So I'm going next week on Thursday for, is it Tuesday or Thursday? I gotta be sure, guys. No, Tuesday I have an appointment with Dr. Rachel Bluebaum. Yes, my SRS surgeon, my new SRS surgeon. And I have Thursday an appointment with radiology for the images of my skull, my face, my bones, so he can see where I want. And I've already told him what I wanted, and he put it in the computer. So yeah, I'm gonna look amazing, I hope. Anyway, so while I was there, I made an appointment for a consultation to see Dr. Rachel Bluebon. And so I go next Tuesday to see her. Like, I'm trying to hurry up and get in there, because I'm not letting, if I can help it, I'm not letting Ting touch me. Now, the difference between the experience of the two places, the two hospitals is, okay, when I went in for consultation, they told me that you're only going to spend 2-3 days here, and it's really 2 days. On the third day, they kick you out and you go home. Let's keep it real. That's what happens. On the third day of your surgery, they literally kick you out the door. You have, and they told me that over and over. So there's no, you come home with a catheter, a vacuum, a wound vacuum. What's wrong with me tonight? I just had one sip. I swear to you, I have not drank before this. A wound vac, you're going to have a catheter and something else. Catheter or wound? Oh, packing. Lots and lots of fucking uncomfortable packing stuff that's inside of you when you leave Dr. Ting's office. You're going home literally with all that shit. Could you imagine, guys? It doesn't matter who's taking care of me at that point. That's a lot to come home with. That's unsafe. So, the difference between them and NYU, Langone on 41st Street in Manhattan is Dr. Rachel Bluebon's assistant told me today that, yesterday she told me that, she said, she broke down a few things really quick. She was like, you will be in the hospital for 5 days. And I'm like, really? 5 days? Because in Dr. Ting's clinic, you gotta go home after the third day. Like, the third day, you literally are pushed out the door, and they're not letting you stay there. I asked them, could I stay? And they told me no. She says, no. I said, could you imagine me coming home with all that stuff inside of me? That's so unsafe. Like, I feel so uncomfortable with that. That's been in my head for the longest. It's been giving me migraines. She said, no. You're gonna stay here for 5 days. You will have all of that taken out of you when you're discharged. You will go home. The only thing you need to worry about when you go home is recovering. You shouldn't have to worry about anything inside of you. And that's it. Thank you, God. She was like, when you come on Tuesday, she's going to examine you. You're going to see 3 different people. With Dr. Ting, I only saw him. That was it. He spread my legs, checked everything out down there, didn't talk. He said, okay, well, you know, try to stretch the skin a little more, I think he said. And then he says, okay. And he walked out the door. That was it. With Dr. Rachel Bluebon, she says, you're going to see 3 different people. You're going to see the doctor. She's going to talk to you about orgasms. She's going to ask you about the orgasms that you're having presently. It's because if you are having them now, you should have no problem getting one when you get your new puss, bitch. So, she said that after I leave her and she checks me out, then I'm going to see another doctor. And then I'm going to see another person. So 3 people in one day on that visit. Amazing. It's going to be very thorough. Very, very thorough. I'm ready for it, guys. I'm so fucking hyped. I'm already, I got on the phone yesterday and today I spoke to my doctor. And so I'm getting my support letters ready. But even without all 3 of the support letters, like, I still can get to my visit on Tuesday, like, because the letters are on their way. So anywho, but as soon as the letters come, I get a date. I get a surgery date, you guys. Yes. So Dr. Rachel Bluebon, let's keep our fingers crossed. Let's pray if we pray. Let's talk to the universe if we're talking to the universe. Let's talk to Buddha. Let's talk to whoever you talk to, but just talk to whoever you need to talk to for me, because I want everything to go smoothly, because Dr. Rachel Bluebon is amazing, and I had her as an option, but I kept seeing, you know, the stuff that Ting was doing. Ting was more famous than Dr. Bluebon, but Dr. Bluebon's work is excellent. It's way better than his. Like, aesthetically, her work is beautiful. It looks okay. For instance, I know a girl I specifically know one girl that I'm friends with who is a coordinator at a place, and at a trans center, well, an LGBT center. And I think right on the first day that I met her, she showed me hers on the phone, you know, a picture of hers. And I went, wow, that's nice. And she was like, so when are you looking to do it? And I was like, this was like two years ago. Yeah, this was like 2 years ago. And it took me this long to finally get back to full circle, back to Dr. Rachel Bluebond, because all that time I was busy following what I saw on social media. I Am Jazz and Emily on YouTube, just different celebrities, people that went to team, celebrities, and it was doing half as work. You'd have to go back for a revision, and then it was nice after he did it. But Dr. Bluebond gets it right the first time, and it's beautiful, and it looks like it should have always been there. Like, hers look like, I mean, like a regular cisgender woman's. When she does it, it looks like a regular cisgender woman's vajayjay. So that's who I'm going to go see. That's my choice. They don't know yet over there at Ting's office, but they will know very shortly, because I'm going to let them know as soon as I get my date for my surgery with Dr. Rachel Bluebond. I'm going to let Ting know. But in the meantime, I'm still doing my electrolysis. So my electrolysis, I got to go back on the 17th, I think. Yeah. No, not the 17th. Is it the 17th? I think so, you guys. Anyway, sometime the 21st, something like that. But I'm still doing electrolysis. So, because unlike Ting, where you could still have some hair and be okay with it, Dr. Rachel Bluebond, once again, no. All of that area must be cleaned out, free of freaking hair. Which is the right thing to do, because who wants hair growing inside of their vaginas? Ew. Can you imagine, you guys? Gross. So anyway, I'm happy about that, guys. I'm so happy about that. And cheers, bitch. Biden is in office pretty soon. So that's a weight lifted off my head. But let's try out this panini, you guys, really quick. I'm gonna let you know what it tastes like. So these are the, I don't know if I showed you the, it's made by Natural Corner. It's called Garden Panini Pasta. Ooh, and it has like a vegan cheese sauce. So it's not real cheese, it's vegan cheese, which is actually pretty good. I tasted it earlier. I think it says vegan, all natural. I think the pasta could be cooked a little bit more. It's a little chewy for my taste. Yeah, it's like chewing gum. But let me show you my half the turkey that I cooked tonight. So yeah, you guys, I am working on going vegan. So I plan to be completely vegan sometime next year. Don't quote me, but sometime next year I want to be completely all the way vegan. So let me show you my masterpiece. Now she's cute, girl. She's moist. And I'm going to fuck her up. I'm about to fuck her up. I promise you. With some of this panini pasta. That's going to be my dinner. But I love you guys. Thank you for watching Dr. Rachel Bluebond at 41. Dr. Rachel Bluebond at 44th Street in Manhattan, NYU Langone, hospital, plastic surgery. So yeah, that's where I'm getting everything done. I'm getting my face done there. I'm getting my boobs done there. I'm getting my vagina done there. All of it done in one motherfucking place. What? I'll keep you guys updated. I love you so much. Do me a favor, share this video, let all the girls know about Dr. Rachel Bluvon if they don't know already. And I'm gonna thank all the women who actually hit me up privately and told me about teeing. Even when I didn't ignore, obviously, as you see, I didn't ignore you because I brought it to his attention and I brought the pictures with me so he can see. So he was embarrassed, and that's why he got shady with me in the office. He was embarrassed that I showed him those photos, and that's why he said, so what am I supposed to do, Kajin? You're supposed to do great work since you have this big title. You know, oh, that was 3 years ago. 3 years ago, you've been, you know, this huge surgeon. You have this big name. 3 years ago, you should have been doing amazing work. What are you doing? These women should not be botched. These women should not be depressed behind some work that you did to them. So it's not that I didn't pay attention to you. It's just that I was in a place where I was so confused. I'm like, I don't want, this was my second time. My third time going for the surgery, and something ended up happening. The first time I went, my blood work didn't come back right because my blood pressure was really messed up, and my liver enzymes were really high, so they canceled it, and I went into a depression. This was 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, and then came around again last March, and the pandemic hit. So they shut me down again because of the pandemic. And then I said, okay, I don't want to lose out again. Like, this is so important to me. Like, this will, you know, I'll feel more complete once this is done. Like, I can't miss this opportunity. So even when you were telling me and warning me about him, I was still thinking, okay, well, I can't, maybe it's a hit and miss thing with people, because that's what some people are saying. But that's bullshit. There's too many women that are talking about his work. Too many were coming to me and saying things. I'm in post-op groups on Facebook. Now, these groups are important. These women have respect for each other. They're in there consoling one another, and they are helping one another, and I love that about them. There's a sisterhood, and there's respect. More than anything, there's respect. It's not like a group where people go and read each other and throw shade and... No, these are grown women who support one another, and that's what they're there for. I go in that group maybe once a month just to sit and talk and ask questions, and they answer the questions. Someone will answer the questions for me. One girl in particular, we become friends, so I really don't have to go in the group anymore, to be honest, you guys. I know the person personally, so we talk. She and I talk on a regular basis, so I don't really have to go in the group at all. But find yourself a support team. Find yourself for whatever it is that you need. I am going to still open up a group for trans women, women of trans experience, women such as myself. Open up a group for us, and it's for domestic violence and domestic violence and rape and, you know, things like that. So, I've been through all of that. I've been through domestic violence with my ex-husband, my ex-fiance. I've also been raped multiple times. So, I will be leading the group. It will be a very private group. I'm working on that. I'm also working on a few other things. You know how I am. I wait until I have really good, solid, you know, information on things that are going to happen for me before I start announcing it. So I already have something in the making with someone, and it's really good news, and I'm so glad. God is good, child. The universe is good too. Now, the same God, everybody has a different God. Just know that. So when I say God, don't think it might be the same one that you're talking about. Hallelujah! Nothing wrong with that one. Praise who you want to praise. I was raised in a Baptist church. But when I say God, I mean I have a higher power. And I know who I believe my higher power is. So, I say thank you, God. And I say thank you to the universe because I believe in what things, what goes around, come around. So when you're evil and you're shady to people, remember, that stuff comes back to you. Tenfold sometimes. So be kind to people, y'all. Help somebody else. You know? Don't be selfish. Help someone. Help without wanting something back. How about that? Give. Give unconditionally to people. There shouldn't be any conditions on things that you do or give to someone, you know. And so that's what I feel from this person that I've been working on some of the business aspects with. And I'm really happy about that because I'm happy that things are finally looking up for me. You know, things are finally going the way that I've always wanted it to go. So I'll let you know the details about it another time. But we have to get everything straight first and everything like a really solid deal before I can talk about it. But know that there are some things in the making, and it has to do with Kayshen's outreach for the homeless. I love y'all, and thank you for supporting me, for whoever's watching, and keep watching, and I'll come back with some more stuff tomorrow. So share the video, guys. Hit the like button for me, too. Don't forget to hit the like button. Y'all always forget to hit the like button. I love you. Love you, ladies. Love you, gentlemen.